This is Realtime Rendering in RELUX Desktop. In the Start New element, you have this button Realtime Rendering. You can switch it on, switch it off with this button. If it's on, you have the separate window. This is separated from the main RELUX Desktop application, which brings you the freedom to move it freely around and also to change the size of the screen. Highly recommended to use a second monitor just for this visualization, independent from the main RELUX Desktop application. In this Realtime Rendering windows, it's possible to move freely around the camera with the WASD buttons and the mouse. With Q and E, you can lower and rise the position of the camera. It's also possible to connect a gamepad to Windows and use a game controller in order to operate the camera here, which plays in some. If activated, it's also possible to change here directly positions of objects. You can move objects 3D around, change the texture, change everything. For example, here at the Lumina, you can change the position where the spot should be going to. And here it's, you can see immediately the effects on the shadow and on the presence of this apple here. It's also possible to dim down, for example. Here, this wall elements are a bit too bright for me. Here, I can dim down to a lower level and have a bit of more presence to the spot. And including also the color, it's possible to change the color to a nice magenta, for example, if you like this color or if you want to play around with some colorish lights. Yeah, if activated, you have also here a new ribbon element called Realtime Rendering. This brings you all the options and possibilities to work with Realtime Rendering. First to mention, here you have a button, Use RELUX Camera. This button connects the camera of the Realtime Rendering with the desktop camera. And here you can connect both. And if you do something here on the camera in RELUX Desktop, then it goes directly also to the Realtime Rendering camera. And also you can disconnect it again and you are now independent again. Also possible to use daylight in this Realtime Rendering. By switching on daylight, you got daylight, and here you can select the date and the time in order to change the daylight direction. And yeah, it's also possible to do it directly here with the U and the I button. In this window, you can change U and I button the time. And it's also possible to change the cloud density. Cloud density has also an impact on the diffuseness on the daylight. Here you can select the render quality from ultra to low. I would recommend to start with high if you have a graphic card. And if you have a really great powerful graphic card, you can try ultra, and if you have a weak graphic card, to go lower. It's also possible to take screenshots of this window, and this comes with a kind of options here. You can change resolution, panorama, you can open it internally, externally, and so on. And the screenshots going also in the output path in order to use it for your outputs. That's all. Thanks.